Hello, welcome along. I'm Jeff. This is our watercolour that we're doing today. It's just a misty scene of a couple of boats just sitting there in the still water. Very simple, minimalist watercolour. Hardly anything in that one, so it's a fairly simple one to do. So we'll start off with the sky, and we'll just use some clean water with a fairly large brush. That's the boats there, as you can see. A little bit of that land in the background. Here we go with the clean water. Actually, I don't know why I'm going along the horizon there. I've just realised I need to do the whole page, to wet the whole page. There we go, it's got the whole page covered. And I'm using peach, the colour peach, P-E-A-C-H, with a tiny little bit of yellow ochre in there. I'm also using a little bit of cobalt blue. This is the cobalt blue now. It's got a tiny, tiny bit of Payne's grey with that cobalt blue. I'm going to extend it down into where the water area is. There we are. I want this to be light, very, very light and misty. Again, it's on 300 GSM paper. And here's that peach, you can see. And it's got a tiny bit of yellow ochre in it, but you can see the peach colour there. So I'm just painting the one of the boats here. This is a mixture of, just some little bit of cobalt blue. There's some Payne's grey in there. There's a little bit of burnt umber, sort of a bit of a muddy mixture. And I want the left-hand side that you can see me painting there, I want that to be darker. And that will have to be mirrored in the reflection as well. Thank you. painting some little bits on the ships there, or on the boats. So, painting the mast. That line of that mast may look a tiny bit thin. I might have to thicken that up a bit. I'm going to grab a rigger brush, very thin, and they call it rigger brush because a lot of artists use it to do the rigging of ships that I'm doing right now. And of course you can see that main mast is a bit too thin, so I'm going to have to thicken that up. And I want here we go, and to thicken up the other one just a tiny bit using burnt umber. Painting the reflection now of these two boats, and I'm using some Payne's Grey, a little bit of cobalt blue, and a tiny little bit of burnt umber, just a tiny bit. working on that reflection there. Very light, watered down variation of those same colours I used in the reflection. So only a few colours used here. There's peach, P-E-A-C-H, peach. Little tiny bit of yellow ochre. There's burnt umber being used, some Payne's grey and cobalt blue. Putting some marks or lines on these boats. I want to be those boats to be darker on the left-hand side. I was painting along the horizon there. There's just a strip of land in the background there. I don't want it to be too dark. I want it to be fairly soft. just almost the same colours as that reflection, but even watered down a bit further. Yep, you can see it taking shape. It's almost finished. Just fix up a little bit here on the boat. Couple of birds in the sky. Want them to be fairly soft. You can barely see that, but I want the birds, I don't want the birds standing out too much. I want them more in the background. Yep, that might do it. Remember, pull the tape away from the paper. There it is. Hope you enjoyed that. Please subscribe and click the bell icon. And it's just a very simple idea. You can try this one at home. Very minimalist watercolour, and they can sometimes be some of the best. Again, thanks for watching. Subscribe, click the bell icon, and I'll be back with another watercolour fairly soon. I really appreciate you watching. There's other watercolour channels to check out as well. We each have our own unique approach. Hope you enjoy mine. Bye for now.